Aleluia.
Aleluia.
Aleluia. We are all welcome to the service today in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we bless the name of God for everyone that are here and those that are still coming. Hallelujah.
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 First of all, I want to appreciate the Almighty God for what He did last week.
Hallelujah.
And we appreciate every one of us.
Hallelujah.
Mommy, we appreciate you.
Hallelujah.
Choir, we appreciate you.
Hallelujah.
You've done wonderfully. Hallelujah. Every member, we thank you. We appreciate you for everything, for your gifts. We thank you very much. You are so amazing. God bless you.
Amen.
Amen. God will continue to lift us up. And that place we are going, we all get there.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We are going to look at the word of God. I won't take much of our time. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And the topic of today's message is rejoicing in hope. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Rejoicing in hope. Can we rejoice?
Yes.
When we are still hoping for something,
yes,
that one day my God will do it.
Yes.
Because He has promised it, and I believe that He is going to do it. Can we rejoice before that time? Before that thing comes to pass, can we rejoice? That's what we are going to look at this afternoon. Hallelujah. I believe we can do it. We can put up so much excitement, expecting that thing that God has given, God has promised us that He is going to happen. He is going to turn out the way He has said it. Hallelujah. Concerning the Lord, concerning the church of God, hallelujah, He is going to turn out to be just as He has said it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Just as He said that He's going to send Jesus Christ, so He was. When the time came, when the fullness of time came, Jesus Christ showed up. Amen. And I believe God that as the time comes, amen, as we go on, the promise of God for your life, for the church of God, it will surely manifest. But before then, we have to rejoice. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't know how much you place on rejoicing on the, you know, what God has said, but I believe God so much that what He said He will do, He will do it. Hallelujah. He said rejoicing in hope. And hope is an optimistic state of mind that is based on an expectation of positive outcomes.
Hallelujah.
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 Optimistic.
Yes.
You are so excited. I said, I believe God. Just as God has said it, how it's going to happen in my life, in my family, in the church of God. Hallelujah. How many of us believe that? If you believe that, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If God says He's going to hear you, I don't care what you are going through right now. If God said He has done it, He's going to bless you. I don't care about your circumstances right now. He's going to bless you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do you believe that? Before then, I want us to continue to reach in the expectation that which God has said, it will surely come to pass. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He said, with respect to events and circumstances in one's life or the world at the large. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
No doubt that event that God says is going to bring to pass on this mountain, in my life, in your life,
yes, Lord,
that event will surely come to pass.
Come
before Him. Rejoice.
Yes, Lord.
Rejoice.
Amen.
You know what? During that time, it's not easy to rejoice when you are going through challenges, trials of life. But one thing that I believe is that during that time, God will test your character. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And one of our character is that, are you really rejoicing? That's why Paul said, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. You know, when you are rejoicing in the face of challenges, devil will run away from you.
Yeah.
Devil don't like it. Why? You know, I'm doing all this. Why are you still rejoicing? Because I'm rejoicing in hope.
Hallelujah.
That my God, the God that I serve,
yes,
will surely bring to pass,
amen,
what He has said.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He will bring to pass,
amen,
what He has said,
amen,
concerning you,
amen,
concerning the church of God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
promises or expectation with confidence. Expectation with confidence that nothing that can change it. I so much believe in what God has said. I have confidence in Him. Hallelujah. I have confidence in Him. So He said, so it will be. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Before then, let's open our Bible to the book of Romans. We are going to look at some examples in the Bible. Hallelujah. People that they are in hopeless situation, right off situation, but God turned it around to His glory. And I pray that this afternoon, I don't know what you are going through, and I don't know what God has said about that circumstances, about that situation. What I want to assure you this afternoon, I want you to rejoice before Him, believing that that which God has said concerning you, it will surely come to pass. Amen. Amen. Shall we open to the book of Romans, chapter? A very familiar scripture in the Bible, book of Romans, chapter 5 first. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Romans 4, 5. Romans 5, 1 to 5. Shall we read that quickly?
Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God.
Yes.
Through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom also we have access by faith into the grace wherein we stand, and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. Verse 3. And not only so, but we glory in tribulation, also knowing that tribulations work patience, and patience experience, and experience hope. Verse 5. And hope maketh not ashamed.
Hallelujah.
Because the love of God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Holy Ghost that is dwelling inside of you. Hallelujah. He's dwelling inside of you. I don't know about, do you believe that the Holy Spirit is dwelling inside of you? He's the one that will be giving you that which you need at every moment, at every second. He will never leave you. He said he's a comforter. Amen. He's the revealer of the secrets. He's the one that will reveal to you that, look, I know you've been patient enough, but it's not time yet. Your time is not right yet. I'm going to do it. I've said it. Just have that confidence. Build up that confidence in me. Before then, continue to take your stand. Amen. Continue to grow in me. Hallelujah. That song, hallelujah, we are going to a higher place. Amen. Hallelujah. And as that song's writer says, see, my faith is built on nothingness. Hallelujah. It's only in the righteousness of our Lord Jesus Christ. And he says, faith is the substance of the things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. Amen. If you believe in something that you've seen already, that's not faith. Amen. It's the substance that the Holy Spirit have dropped in your heart. And said, yes, God said. Have you ever wake up in the morning one time and God says something to you? You wake up and you look at yourself. Wow, is that God? Amen. It's God.
Amen.
It's God. It's God that spoke to you.
Yes.
You must believe it. Amen. And build your confidence in that thing that God has said to you. It will happen.
Amen.
If God says He has healed you.
Yes.
Don't care about the circumstances. Don't care about what your body, the symptoms that is facing you at that moment. Believe it. He has already healed you.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. If he says to you that wayward child is coming back home, believe it.
Yes.
That child is coming back.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
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 Because God is the one. It's not man that will lie. We can lie.
Yes.
God will never lie. And when you wake up, you say, wow, is that you, God? He is God. All you need to do is just to grab it. Don't let the devil come and snatch it away by the circumstances, by what is around you, by what is going on. Just grab that one and be like a bulldog that we will never let go the bones. Amen. Hallelujah. That is the faith. Hallelujah. And that's how God wants us to walk with Him. Amen. He wants us to walk with Him by faith, not by sight, not by what we can see, by what He has put in our heart, and it's going to come to pass. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He said, therefore, having been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. It's in Him we have peace. Left with this world, there's no peace in the world. But in our Lord Jesus Christ, we have peace. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Through whom also we have access by faith into the grace in which we stand and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. Hallelujah. We are going to turn to the same book, Romans chapter 4. Hallelujah. Right now. Let's open to Romans chapter 4. Hallelujah. From 17.
As it is written, I have made thee a father of many nations. Before him, whom he believes, even God, who quickened the dead and calleth those things which be not as though they were, who against hope believed in hope, that he might become the father of many nations. According to that which was spoken, so shall that seed be. And being not weak in faith, he considereth not his own body now dead, when he was about 100 years old, neither yet the deadness of Sarah's womb is staggered, nor at the promise of God through unbelief, but was strong in faith, giving glory to God.
Hallelujah. God bless you. Hallelujah. He waxed strong in faith, giving glory to God. Look at Abraham. Look at when God gave him the promise. Genesis chapter 12. That's where he received the promise. Not even a single child. But God promised that he's going to be the father of a nation. He said, calling things that be as though they were. Amen. It don't look like it. That situation doesn't look like it. But as the Lord, we have it. You continue to act stronger and stronger and stronger, giving glory to God in the face of that situation, hopeless situation. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
The doctor might have write you off and say, look, just forget about it. You cannot be healed of that disease. No! God says He has healed you and He will heal you. It will surely come to pass. How God turned hopeless situation around, and your own will not be exception. God will do yours as well. He will turn that hopeless situation. He will turn it around to the glory of His name. Amen. The Bible said Abraham never wavered. He keep on giving glory. I'm the father of nations. No evil single child. I'm the father. You don't have anything. You don't have nothing. And you are proclaiming you are the father of nations. People will look at him and say, are you stupid? He's not stupid. He's rejoicing. Giving glory to God for what God has said. And it's going to come to pass. Does it come to pass or not in the life of Abraham? He did. We are the seed of Abraham.
Hallelujah.
I don't know what you're going through. To be honest with you, God will restore your hope.
Yeah.
He will restore your hope.
Yeah.
He will restore your hope.
Yeah.
You will come out of that situation
yeah.
triumphantly,
yeah.
gloriously,
yeah.
with a myself up and say, well, I better continue to live like that. I don't think anything can be done about it. Don't play with God. Amen. Don't waver at what God has said. All you need to do, continue rejoicing. Press on in the word of God. In the word of God. Hallelujah. You know those moments, they are not, it's not going to be easy though. No, it's not an easy thing. But with the help of God, going deeper in the word of God, looking at the promises of God concerning that situation, concerning what you are going through, it will surely come to pass. It will surely come to pass. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And he said, as a believer, when you are praying for something and God revealed to you through the Holy Spirit that he is going to do it, you have to believe him by faith. And turn your hope up. Turn it up. Hallelujah. Amen. Turn your hope up. Amen. Amen. Don't look down. Look up. Yes. Look up unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. He said, who for the joy that was set before him, despising the shame, endured the cross. Are you enduring that situation? But God has set that joy before you that is going to do it for you. Why are you looking sad? Why are you looking sad? Rejoice in him. Amen. It will surely come to pass. Amen. It will come to pass. Amen. It's not going to be easy, but I want to promise you, according to the word of God, that just as the Lord has said it, it will turn out. Amen. 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 It will happen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't feel discouraged. Don't feel dejected. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Don't feel discouraged. Don't feel dejected. That is what the devil wants in the first place. Devil wants you to be walking around like a defeated. Defeated folks. You are not a defeated one.
Amen.
You are a victorious one. You are a winner.
Hallelujah.
You are a winner.
Hallelujah.
In Christ Jesus, you are a winner. Amen.
Amen.
You are a winner.
Amen.
Let the devil pack up his baggage and go away from you because he has no room in your life. Hallelujah. He has no place in your life.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
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 Let's look at Acts chapter 27. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Acts 27. The Acts of Apostles chapter 27. These people have been in this situation for the shipwreck. They were there, no light. They lost hope. They threw away all they have. Hallelujah. I don't know, maybe you lost something in the process of waiting for God to do something in your life, but God will restore you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Acts chapter 27, let's read from verse 13, quickly, please.
And when the south wind blew softly, supposing that they had obtained their purpose, losing theirs, they sailed close by Crete. But not long after, there arose against it a tempestuous wind called Euroclydon. And when the ship was caught and could not veer up into the wind, we let
her
drive.
Amen. God bless you.
Amen.
We all know what happened here.
Yes,
Paul was taken to Rome as a prisoner.
Amen.
Prisoner of what? Of gospel. Prisoner of hope.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, it's time to appear before Caesar in Rome. But he's going there. Hallelujah. He's going there for a purpose, for missionary purpose. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sorry about that. Sorry. He was taken there as a prisoner.
Yes.
But there was a storm on the way. God bless you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There was a storm along the way. But Paul has already warned the sailor that look where this journey is in danger. But they wouldn't listen to Paul. He's a prisoner anyway. Who wants to listen to a prisoner? Somebody that don't have sin. Amen. But he has sin, but they don't want to listen to him. As they were going, the storm began. Hallelujah.
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 And what happened on the way is that they started to throw all their things aboard. Everything, all their belongings. They've lost everything they have, thinking that by doing that, they will lighten up the ship. Hallelujah. In the process of circumstances in our life, we do so many things that we even throw away that what we're not supposed to throw away. But God, the restorer of life, hallelujah, will restore everything that we might have lost during that process in the name of Jesus. Because He is the only one that can restore. You can look at yourself and say, well, I don't think I can get those things back. But God can restore you, even greater than you expected. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And He said from verse 21, He said, but after long abstinence from food, then Paul stood in the midst of them and said, men, you should have listened to me and not have sailed from Crete and incurred this disaster and loss. And now I urge you to take heart, for there will be no loss of life among you, but only of the ship. For there stood by me this night an angel of the God to whom I belong and whom I serve, saying, do not be afraid, Paul. You must be brought before Caesar. And indeed, God has granted you all those who sail with you. Amen.
Amen.
You will appear before Caesar. That's what I've said. Is that not worth rejoicing?
Yes.
Amen. Don't forget that in the beginning of Paul's commission, God has spoken to him. Jesus said, look, this is what you are going to suffer in the hand of your people, in the hand of the Gentiles, but I am going to be with you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Was God with him or not? And now the angel of the Lord came to him again. He said, do not be afraid, Paul. You must be brought before Caesar. And indeed, God has granted you all those who sail with you. Not even only you, all the people that are around you, that are in the ship with you. I have given you their life. You are all saved. Amen. Just because of one person, the old people who are in the ship, in the ship, they were all saved. Amen. Because of one person, the old ship can be wrecked. Like where our Sunday school. Amen. Jonah. Because of Jonah, the people in the ship will have perished. Hallelujah. They were in trouble. They will have perished in that water. Please, I want to know who you are in Christ. Amen. Know the God that you serve. Know the God that you serve. You cannot serve two masters. Amen. It's not possible. You either serve one and be sold one. Amen. Make sure you serve the living God, the God of Israel, the God of our Lord, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. That is the only true God that we must serve. And if you serve Him, you will never be put to shame. You will never be put to shame. In the name of Jesus. And He said, now when the 14th, He said, therefore take heart, men, for I believe God, that it will be just as it has told me. However, we must run aground on a certain island. Now when the 14th night had come, as we all driven and up and down in the hurrying sea, about midnight, The sailor says that they were drawing near some land. Hallelujah. Because God is already in control of that ship at that moment. Now they sense that something is happening right now. Just as the Lord has said to Paul, exactly that's how it happened. Just as the Lord has said to you, that's how it's going to turn out to be. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Then he encouraged them to eat. Anoint your face. Don't be sad. You've been, you know, for so long you have not been eating. Eat something. Be encouraged. Amen. We need people of encourage and people that can encourage us, people that can speak the word of God to our life. We need the word of God. Let the Holy Spirit do this work for you. Amen. The Holy Spirit is the comforter. He's our teacher. Amen. He's everything to us. So allow him to speak to you. Allow the Holy Spirit to speak to you. Amen. Rhema word or logo word. He can speak to you through the word. He can speak to you through the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Giving you the word of encouragement. The word that can sustain you. The word that can make you to put up rejoicing heart instead of looking sad. Instead of looking like a defeated folks. Amen. You are not defeated.
Yes.
You are a winner.
Amen.
You are a winner.
Amen.
You are a child of God. Sister, what's going on in your life? Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I know it's hard sometimes, but by the help of God, by the help of Holy Spirit, believing that thing you are expecting from me, He will do it.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
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 It says, in the process of time, your character will be tested. Hallelujah. We are going to pray now. Let's open to the book of Hebrew, chapter 12. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hebrew chapter 12. Oh, chapter 6. Sorry. Hebrew 6. From 13.
For when God made promise to Abraham, because he could swear by no greater, he swear by himself, saying, surely blessing I will bless thee, and multiplying I will multiply thee. And so, after he had patiently endured, he obtained the promise. For men verily swear by the greater, and oath for confirmation is to them an end of all strife. Wherein God willing more abundantly to show unto the heir of promise the immutability of his counsel, confirm it by an oath, that by the two immutable things in which it was impossible for God to lie, we might have a strong consolation who have fled for refuge to lay hold upon the oath set before us, which hope we have as an anchor of the soul, both sure and steadfast, and which entered into that within the veil.
Amen. God bless you. Can we see the writing here? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hebrew chapter
6.
6 verse 19.
Yes.
Anchor. I was steadfast. That we can hold on to. That is our Lord Jesus Christ. He's the one that can hold us fast. That we will continue to remain. Hope we have as an anchor. Steadfast. Amen. Believing that Jesus Christ has already come before us. He has already made the way for us. And when we enter through him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We have access to the presence of God
through
him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And that God will never put you to shame.
Amen.
He said, oh, make it not ashamed.
Amen.
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 Hope will never, never disappoint you.
Amen.
He will never put you to shame.
Amen.
For that reason, I don't know if you lost hope. concerning you, he's going to do it.
Amen.
I want to reassure you today that God will restore that hope.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And that which God has said concerning you,
wow,
it will surely come to pass.
Amen.
Believe the word of God.
Yes.
Believe him.
Hallelujah.
Believe him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It will happen.
Amen.
Concerning the church of God, you might look at the empty chairs, but God promised that he's going to do it.
Hallelujah.
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 Rejoice in that.
Amen.
That which God has said, he will do it.
Amen.
He will do it.
Amen.
Shall we rise on our feet?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And we're going back to the book of Romans, chapter 5 again. Romans 5 again. Hallelujah. He said in verse 5, now hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out in our heart by the Holy Spirit who was given to us. Holy Spirit has been given to you, and the love of God is being poured in our heart. And we are going to pray here that God Almighty, as I hope in you, Father, don't let me be put to shame. Don't let my hope in you be cast away. Don't let me be put to shame, because you are my Father. You are the one that I promised. You are the one that has said it. Daddy, don't let me be put to shame. In any way, in any circumstances, don't let me be put to shame. Shall we pray that prayer? Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we come before you this afternoon. Father, don't let your people be put to shame. In any way we are expecting something from you, Lord, Father, don't let us be put to shame. In the name of Jesus, don't allow us to be put to shame. In the name of Jesus, arise in your mighty power. That which you have promised us, that which you have said you are going to do, Father, bring it to pass in our life. In the name of Jesus, that which you have promised us, Father, bring it to pass in our life. In this ministry, Father, bring it to pass, Lord. In the name of Jesus, bring it to pass, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. God's unfailing promise. When God promised you, he's a faithful God. He is the one that I promised, and he is the one that will do it. He will bring it to pass.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't let the devil put fear in you in a way whereby you will feel defeated. Amen. God wants us to walk in victory. He wants us to walk as a winner, not as a defeated foes. Amen. Believe him. Amen. It might be difficult at this moment, but believe what God has said, and it will surely come to pass. We are going to pray again, and Daddy, as you have done it before, I believe you are doing it right now, and I know you are going to do it again, because you are God. You are not a man that will lie. Father, that which you have said concerning us, Father, bring it to pass in the name of Jesus. Shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, here we are in your presence this afternoon, Daddy. We pray, Lord, that everything you have said concerning us, Father, bring it to pass in the name of Jesus. Bring your plan and purpose to pass in the name of Jesus. The plan that you have for us, that you have for this ministry, Father, bring it to pass in the mighty name of Jesus, because you are unfailing God. You are unfailing God. Bring your plan and purpose to pass in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. We're going to pray one prayer before I go. As the year is running to an end, many things will be happening. But I pray good things will happen in your life. Good things will happen in my life. Good things will happen to the people of God. In the name of Jesus. There used to be one saying when it comes to this period of the year that people always believe that, oh, you know what, at this time, there's always evil here, evil there. And true, Satan is using that as a weapon as well to attack people. Amen. There's no every day you hear this bad news here, bad news there. I pray that bad news will not be your portion in the name of Jesus. Bad news will not be your portion in the name of Jesus. We are going to pray that prayer. I said, Lord, as this year is running to an end, Father, keep us safe. Keep us safe. Keep our family safe. Keep the church of God safe. Don't let any evil befall us, Lord. Father, keep us safe, Lord. Shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, as this year is running to an end, Father, keep us safe. Keep the church of God safe. Keep our family safe. In the name of Jesus, keep us safe, Lord. Keep our going out, our coming in. Don't let any evil befall us in the name of Jesus. As we go out, Father, keep us safe. As we come in, keep us safe. In the mighty name of Jesus, let your angels go ahead of us. Let them come behind us. Let them encamp round about us. In the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Our Father and our God, we thank you this afternoon. Daddy, we bless your holy name. We give you glory, we give you honor, we give you all the adoration. We thank you because you are God that never fails. You are God that never put your people to shame. Thank you because you are God of hope. He said, the thought that I have for you, hallelujah, but it's of peace, to give you a future and a hope. Father, we thank you for restoring us, God. Thank you for restoring our hope in you, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for what you have done. Thank you for what you are doing right now. Thank you for what you are still going to do. Daddy, we bless your holy name. Thank you for healing us. Thank you for blessing us. Thank you for the victory you have given to us. Thank you for the deliverance. Thank you for the good things you are doing in our life. Daddy, we bless your holy name. Father, we pray, Lord, that this afternoon, we pray, Lord, that you will renew our hope in you in the name of Jesus. Renew us afresh in the name of Jesus. Is there any area of our life that we have lost hope? Father, come and restore us. Come and restore us. In the name of Jesus, that which we are looking unto you for, as an individual, as we are standing here this afternoon, I believe that God is healing you right now. God is giving you victory right now. God is blessing you right now. In the name of Jesus, that which you are looking unto God for, God is doing it in your life right now. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 God is giving you victory. Victory is yours. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. God is restoring you right now. He is restoring relationship. The name of God. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Amen.